What's up, guys? Ian Sandusky from Lakewood Machine and Tool back here again for Practical Machinist. And today on this episode of Making the Cut, we have a very special treat for you. If you notice those behind me, those are the real Alps here in the south of Germany. We are going to be here today touring a facility that I don't think a lot of people have ever gotten a chance to go inside before, and one that I never thought we would get the chance to go to. We're here at DMG MORI. This is where they build, assemble, produce all their machines, or at least most of the lines of them, from the monoBLOCK style all the way up to machines that are bigger than houses I have lived in. And we're gonna get a very exclusive look and tour right now. Let's go. This just goes on and on and on. This has to be one of the most insane setups I've ever seen in my life. When you say messy, you guys mean German messy, because looking around this place looks very, very nice. This is bigger than some apartments I've lived in. If you wanted to go in and clean that, you might need a ladder.
And here we have almost 1,000 pockets for tools. This is really custom, a customized solution.
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit.
This place goes on forever. So components. This is a machine to make more DMG MORI. You could park a few jumbo jets in here.
Frankly speaking, I think nobody, when he's just looking on our technology, can copy it.
My mind's already absolutely blown. Not a lot of people get to come in here, but we're very lucky to guide us through our tour. We have Cornelius from DMG.
Hi, Ian. Nice.
Thank you very much for joining us today.
So in this facility, we have 1,600 employees. It's our biggest and I think most important factory in Europe of DMG MORI.
And this was the original
Maho.
It used to be Deco Maho. This was the Maho factory.
This was the Maho factory, founded 1920 already, so more than 100 years ago. We started here at that place.
And it looked a little different then, I'm sure.
Even so, I'm here working now for 23 years, and also in that period, in just 20 years, it changed a lot.
Now, I see that you guys are sticking to the very DMG MORI aesthetic here.
Of course. So that is very important to have a really nice look and feel for the operators to make the machines and the machining itself attractive for young employees. So that is a big target, of course, from us. And that means the machines have to look nice as well and be very ergonomic. So, and that is really given here with this machine. One important point, the monoBLOCKs are always five axis. So we see ourselves as five axis champion. And that means that the machine is from the basic standard configuration 5-axis machine capable.
And I'm sure people are very excited to start getting these on their floors.
Of course, they are. So that is our bestseller model. So the monoBLOCK, and out of the monoBLOCK range, around about 600 machines are leaving each year our factory here in Pfronten.
And they're built 100% right here.
100% here in Pfronten, and are then spread all over the world to our customers.
This is top of the line, very exciting to see. Whoa! Yep. This is bigger than some apartments I've lived in. This is crazy.
So that is one size bigger, as you experience, than the monoBLOCK. And that is our, let's say, high-end technology. And here we have also added a pallet system, because automation is key and everybody is talking and needing automation. So therefore we try to develop modular systems for automation. So this kind of pallet system you can integrate not just to this machine, but also to several other machines from DMG MORI. And what you can see here, Ian, so that's a grinding tool we are having here inside. This FDS means the machine is milling, turning, and grinding. So fräsen, drehen, schleifen, so the German words. So it's really technology integration on the highest level.
And it would use the same spindle to do the milling that it uses to do the grinding, all in the same thing?
Yeah, that's the same spindle.
How many of these are you guys producing a year here?
So this dualBLOCK line, we are producing 300 pieces, so more. In four different sizes, somehow.
Tell me about this. This is actually really interesting.
So that is a rotating clear window where even when you are working with the coolant, you have a clear and very transparent view into the working area.
Which is important.
Especially when we are talking about single part machining. So usually the batch sizes are going down. The customers like you probably, tomorrow you do not know what to machine. and therefore you have to set up new parts day by day.
Every single day.
You can really have a close look to the setup procedure of the process then.
Make sure you're not crashing that nice shiny new spindle.
Yeah.
So essentially, if a customer comes to you guys and has an automation issue they need, not only can they buy an off-the-shelf solution, there's some engineering that you guys can actually do for them like this.
Of course, yeah. So in terms of automation, that is often done in most cases customized. So what we see in the beginning, that was standard solutions,
right,
but also modular design. But this is really custom. A customized solution.
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit. This is actually the assembly area. So here we are now in the basic assembly of the dualBLOCK machines.
We do here
the assembly of the basic machine with integration of the electrical cabinet until we switch on the machine, and then we move it to the final assembly, so that you will see afterwards.
How many would you be assembling here at one time?
So it's up to 20 machines are here in the basic assembly prepared.
And how do you guys maneuver these things around this? Oh, is that that giant crane that maneuvers these things around in here?
Yeah, here inside, and then we put on the trolley and forklift, who is then putting it to the final assembly.
Must be a pretty big trolley. Wow. And how many square meters would this place be roughly?
So 90,000 square meters.
90,000.
Yeah. Okay, but now let's look to the heart of the machine tool, the spindle assembly.
Yes.
So that's, I think, the most important component also in terms of accuracy and so on. So there we have also a special assembly area. Here we have our assembly line for the spindles. It's assembled step by step. Here we have the stator line. On the other side, it's the rotor line, and then they are put together and assembled finally. And when the spindle is done so far, it goes to the test area. And there we test it with a whole range of RPM and overnight to get really a proven and tested component to the final assembly then.
On each and every single spindle.
Each and every single spindle. And of course, not just for our assembly, but also for the spare part supply. Yeah.
And one thing I do see here, this is a trend I've seen, is that you guys have essentially, it looks like, eliminated drawers. This is something I've seen a lot lately, and it seems like you guys are doing a really good job of it, where every tool has a place.
Yeah.
Those tools go there. When they're done, they go back.
And here you see, Ian, the test of the spindle. So it's really, or we try to test the spindle in that configuration, like it's then used in the machine tool.
Okay.
So it's with a cooling unit, it's additional with temperature sensor, so that we see how the bearings are behaving, also with maximum RPM, and then the component goes tested to the final assembly. These were assembled today, these spindles, now tested and going to, on Monday then, to the assembly line. Yeah.
Oh, it's that quick? You let them run over the weekend?
Automated. So over the weekend, all automated, and then they are going to the...
And are these machines ones that you guys obviously either built or had a hand in building these testing machines?
So that is own development, so 100%.
So you're not just buying a machine and slapping a DMG MORI sticker on
No.
These are manufactured,
that's really,
designed by
even
you.
If it's not the classic machine tool, but this test equipment is also made by DMG.
What is this thing here?
So that is the portal machine, DMU210. And there, for example, you see also this, let's say, bridge of the trunnion table on the machine where we are machining that.
Wow. Now, is this a specialized machine you guys built for production, or is this a modified version of?
You can buy it.
You can buy this if you want.
Yeah. If you want, you can sign the contract today.
I'll get it out there. I'll put it in my carry-on luggage. Is that the
pallet
system?
That is a pallet pool. That is also a pallet pool, with five pallets then in the system. Yeah, also targeting on machining hours, just to run the machine all day long,
This is a room. It's an entire room in there.
Yeah.
That you can machine in if you feel so inclined. Yeah. Everywhere I look, I just see organization, organization, organization. Looks like everything has a place where it has to be, and it's there.
Yeah, at least that's the target.
Well, if that's a target, you guys are doing a pretty good job of it.
Here we are now in the monoBLOCK Excellence Factory, where we are building these monoBLOCKs. What I showed you at the beginning, the second generation, first and second generation are built here at the moment, 65 up to 95, so three or four different models. And the machines are moving constantly, so they are standing on AGVs. And during the assembly process, they are moving 40 millimeters per minute.
14 millimeters per minute.
Per minute, 34 AGVs are moving here in the assembly line. And yeah, from the beginning up to the final acceptance test run. And then at the end of the assembly, they go to the dispatch area then.
You know, I've seen this on TV done with cars. I've never would have imagined that that's how this is done for machines with a level of sophistication, the amount of components like these. Yeah. And the amount of weight.
Yeah. So it's more than 20 tons can be handled by these AGVs. And here you see where we start with from here with the final assembly, adding the electrical cabinet, the spindle, the tool magazine until the final test run. And also on these AGVs, we are doing the geometrical test of the machine. So laser measurement of the machine, of the linear axis, everything is done here.
On an AGV.
On the AGV where we start with. That is also finally then the one where we put the machine off to the dispatch area then.
Just complete efficiency.
Yeah. So that is the main point, that we are here highly efficient and increased our productivity with this assembly concept really to a next level. You can see we add then the housing, the cabin of the machine. So step by step after.
Oh, they just roll in. So boop, that one goes, they put that on. The next one, boop, the door goes on.
Yeah.
Wow.
Before we introduced that 3 years ago, we had an assembly line for the monoBLOCK where we were moving once a day the machine. Ah. And now we are in this continuous flow. That's so even more efficient than moving it once a day just. Here you see how the machine should be at that stage.
Oh, it's got fluid with the cabin and everything.
Everything done.
These things have full interactive displays on them if you need to move it, back it up, whatever it may be.
Yeah. And also what status the machine has then, and to also, again, like in the spindle assembly, to do the documentation here of the assembly steps they did. And yeah, the very impressive thing I think is that we are also doing the measurement on these AGVs. Yeah, so that was really quite a tricky part to develop this.
But I think it was a little more difficult than that. I think you might be underselling that part a little bit. So once these come off this line, they're finished.
They're finished. Here we have then dualBLOCK assembly, and on the next hall, a portal assembly. Nice, beautiful products we are producing here and developing here.
So look how big the envelope is on that one.
Really fun. So that is the 210, so it's our smallest portal machine. So you will even see a little bit bigger then.
Smallest. Yes. That's what I would use to describe this. Yeah, smallest. Oh my, and you guys have a giant glass window door thing there, and straight out is just mountains. Wow. This is, not only is it gorgeous inside, it's in a gorgeous location. I couldn't be happier.
So here you see 340, so that is then the next biggest portal machine. So that's almost size of a small house.
It's bigger than my old house. Yeah, it is. Yeah. Now, who would put something like, is aerospace? Like, what's the industry for a size this big?
Also here, it's very different branches. So aerospace, mold and die, also 340. But what we got last year, many orders from the semiconductor industry.
Really?
Yeah.
Just for giant semiconductors?
No. For the machines that are producing the semiconductors, wafers. So the machines producing these wafers, they are needing big basic components with highest accuracy. And these are machined on 340s, so that is really...
And despite being a giant machine, what would the precision on a machine like this be?
So when we are talking, we have these micro precision machines, so that is really the highest level you can get then. There we are talking about, in that size, 10, 15 microns.
Over a travel of feet and feet and feet.
3.4 meters.
Wow. The size of that thing is difficult to believe. It's funny there. Because when I'm walking around in here, I don't even realize that's a machine until you tell me it's a machine.
So that is where we have also the bigger cranes then here with 100 tons for these kind of machines. So this machine is the biggest we are producing here in Pfronten, a DMU 600P. In that version with a double table version, so you can use just one or add these two tables to one big table.
So this is a machine to make more DMG MORIs?
Yes. Yeah.
Of course it is. Wow. I don't think I've ever seen a machine with a full ladder and cage on it before. That's a new one for me. Is that a rotary table?
That is a rotary table. So mill turning table. So there we have up to 200 RPMs. 50,000 Newton meter torque on the table. So where the customer is then doing turning operations additionally with really 5 meters diameter.
And 200 RPM with a table that size and heavy, that's actually very fast.
Yeah. That's very fast. Here we have milling heads, different milling heads, and we can exchange this automatically.
Oh, that tool changes in there.
Yeah. So that is the standard milling tools, the cutters here inside with our wheel type magazine. And here we have the milling heads that can be exchanged as well.
God.
So with a vertical, with a B axis, A axis, an angular head. So
just supreme modularity.
Yeah. Okay, so here in our logistics center, we started operation last year, as I mentioned, 14 kilometers of rack length. What we have here, 16 meter height of the hall and 8,400 square meters.
You could park a few jumbo jets in here.
Yeah. So wow. Transport trucks, they are unloaded here inside. Then the goods are coming on this conveyor belt. And here at the end, we are scanning the components and then see which size they have, and then the system is looking for the right storage place inside the racks.
Come
automatically.
On.
Yeah.
Come on. Really?
Yeah.
So this is a giant, not only does this whole
conveyor
thing move,
belt.
It tells you, it knows what it is and then tells you where to put it.
Yeah.
Wow, and it would monitor, it would know exactly, if I said I want this component, it would go and tell me exactly where it is.
Yes, of course.
Wow. Everything's automated here. And if it's not automated,
everything.
It's getting
some steps to go, but we are targeting to a higher level.
And despite how big this place is back here, how many people will work in this area roughly?
Here in this area, it's 15.
Well, thank you very much for your time today. I really appreciate you giving us such an in-depth tour of your location. This has been absolutely fantastic.
Thank you very much for being with us, and hope to see you in the future again here in Pfronten at our open house next year probably. So let's see.
Don't threaten me with a good time. And if people want to learn more about DMG MORI, where can they go?
DMGMORI.com. So they find everything, almost everything, and also many insights to our products, to our facilities. So there is much information available there.
Beautiful. Thank you very much for watching, guys. Make sure you turn on notifications below and like and subscribe to make sure you never miss a video. Thank you very much for watching, guys. You take care.